Actually, the what happens in village stays in village.
Hey guys, welcome back to episode 2 of To Tokyo with Love. And wow, the Olympics, the last few sessions have been insane.
Some crazy results. I mean, me and you were screaming at the laptop screen at times. Amazing matches. Timo's gone, Harimoto's gone. Some major upsets today, but really, really exciting stuff.
Yeah, if you looked at the seeds before the event, you would not be thinking right now what the quarterfinal draw is. It's crazy, some of the upsets and the performance of players.
It's been so unpredictable. I mean, none more so than Harimoto getting knocked out against Darko Jorgic, which was actually our match to catch game yesterday where you could win that signed DHS ball. But don't worry, if you missed out there, we have another match to catch game where you can predict the score and win that signed DHS ball later on in the show. So stay tuned for that.
You sure can. So on screen here, we've got the 4 notable results from the last 2 sessions, Tom. And wow, just look at those.
Well, we couldn't start anywhere else other than Harimoto getting knocked out by Darko Jorgic, followed up by Jung Young Sik taking out Timo Boll. Big shock there again, Dan. Yeah. Match 3, we've got Britt Ireland taking out Dina Meshref. She was 3-0 down there, managed to come back and win. And finally, Omar Asar with a 4-3. Again, another 7th set, taking out Matthias Falk, the Swedish player. Lots to look into there, Dan. What do you think really from those games stands out to you?
I know for me, it is the Harimoto and Darko Jorgic. I couldn't believe how well Darko was playing. He was backhand switching down the line. He was competing with Harimoto's best weapon.
I actually feel he out-Harimoto'd Harimoto.
Yeah.
He was giving him the backhand, which Harimoto usually, you know, just smashes people off the table with. Darko Jorgic was giving him a taste of his own medicine.
And he was so confident with it. There was times where Darko missed a few and I was like, oh, he's going for too much there. But he just stuck at it and it paid off.
Yeah, it really was stunning.
And again, that's a huge upset. But of course, Timo going out as well. I mean, I think for a lot of fans out there are gutted that, you know, they feel like they can get further. But Jung Young Sik, he was strong on the day. You know, he was pressuring Timo, finding the wide forehand.
Yeah, don't forget as well, the match before that, Jung Young Sik was 3-1 and 10-4 down against Giannis, the Greek chopper. Managed to come back and win. So that momentum, I'm sure, would have helped him come through against Timo.
And a lot of players have said that. It's not easy going into your opening round against someone who's already had a load of games under their belt. Very difficult and it's not that Timo was cold, but Jung Young Sik was on fire, very used to the conditions.
Exactly right.
Now, talking of comebacks, Tom, Britt Ireland came back from 3-0 down too.
Massive, massive turnaround. Usually in that kind of situation, it's mentally very tough, you know, to turn that round 3 sets behind. Did really well to come back and manage to overturn that result and clearly delighted to get through to the next round.
Now, we do have an exclusive interview from Darko Jorgic after his win with Harimoto. Let's see what he's got to say.
Yeah, it's just amazing performance for me, amazing feeling for me to be in quarterfinal. Beating Harimoto in his own country is just amazing feeling. I was dreaming for this feeling when I was a kid, when I started to play table tennis. In Slovenia, I always said I want to be number one in the world. That's why I'm fighting, practicing a lot, and yeah.
So Darko Jorgic there, understandably, absolutely delighted being able to take out Harimoto in his home Olympics, and he'll be a real threat in the next round.
Yeah, big threat indeed. Now, we do have our special guest to join us now, Soren Primorac, who is a 7-time Olympian. Let's tune in now.
Hey, how are you guys?
Yeah, how are you doing?
Doing well, I'm doing well. I'm enjoying the matches. It's nice. We had a beautiful mixed doubles finals. I was really excited. All beauty of table tennis was in one match.
Yeah, great for Japan to win as well.
I felt Mizutani was extremely motivated. And I know him. He played 2 years in my club and I never saw him hot like this. It was so good.
What did you think of Mimi Ito in the final? I mean, I thought she was amazing, wow. Especially in the final set. Came flying out.
Yeah, I mean, I forgot to pay credit to her because I saw first 2 sets. She was like a little bit struggling, making some easy mistakes. And after, it was like some switch in her head, moved to another dimension. I will not let this match pass. And then mentally, just like reshaped her head and she played unbelievably good. I mean, she was equal to Mizutani and playing some really important points against Su Xin, which was amazing.
Yeah. We've seen some other interesting upsets. Timo Boll just got knocked out by Jung Young Sik. And I don't know if you saw the previous match when he played Giannis, but he was... What was it, 3-1 and 6 match points down?
3-1, 10-4 down, Jung Young Sik against Giannis.
And came back to win. Crazy.
Yeah, I mean, you see this tournament. Sometimes I know when I was playing, then when you pass one round like this, when you save many match points, then you get extremely boost of confidence. Yeah. Timo Boll, he was not on his best. You see that he's a little bit slower. And we have to admit that he's playing differently Olympics than the other tournaments. He's always a little bit nervous than a normal tournament. I see how he's playing European Championships. He won, I forgot how many times he won. But I mean, he's playing like he's playing like in his club. Yeah. But when you see Olympics, it's really something special for him. And then there is a little bit sort of hesitation and feel that it's not the same Timo like it's normal tournament. Yeah. But okay, I mean, we have to pay credit to him because what he did for a sport and what he's still doing for a sport is amazing.
So Zoki, men's and women's gold medal singles prediction. Who do we think is going to get it?
I will say in the men's singles, Fan Zhendong, and in the women's singles, one of these two Chinese girls, but I cannot predict. But I think the Chinese girl, one of these two will win. If you want to win the big title, you have to deserve it. You have to go for it. And this is the key issue in every sport.
I mean, no one's going to give you any Christmas presents, especially at the Olympics.
Yeah,
that's for sure.
Of course.
Do you have any stories that you've not ever told anyone, I guess, publicly that you could share with us that's funny? Like, you don't know, you might have... Something might have happened with some players or hotel or village, the Olympic village.
Actually, what happens in village stays in village. I was a flag bearer in Sydney in Olympics, and this was extremely big honor for me. And I remember this feeling when we were in front of the stadium, and then when they said they pronounced Croatia Kovasi, and then after you take your flag and you take the whole delegation behind you and you lead them. I cannot imagine what kind of feeling I had. I was so proud, and then I was felt like
a superhero.
I'm the guy. They choose me to represent my country among all the famous sports and what we had, and this honor will stay forever in my life.
We want to ask you a good one. So if you were stuck on a desert island and you had to pick one table tennis player to be with you, who would that be? And it can't be from your nation. It's got to be someone from outside Croatia.
I will just put it like who was reliable as a player. Maybe Jean-Philippe Gassien. He was a good guy. He dealt well with the pressure. He was the team player. That means I could cope with him quite well.
That's really interesting because Save picked him.
Jean-Michel Save picked him too.
Yeah, this is good.
So all three of you are going to be stuck on an island.
Yeah.
Gatian, yourself and Save. That's a great island.
That's a strong island.
Paradise Island.
Yeah. Thanks very much for your time. Really appreciate you coming on and chatting to us today. It's been great.
Yeah, thanks.
Thank you very much. It was a pleasure, and I'm really enjoying the Olympics, and I hope to see you soon, guys. The next time we're going to try again this Primrose carbon racket. Remember that.
Oh, yes, definitely. Good fun. All right, Zoki. Brilliant. So from us to Tokyo with love.
Guys, from Tokyo with love, all the best and see you soon.
See you soon, Tokyo. Bye.
It's a really good chat with Zoran there. I really love his passion for the sport, and you can see it really come through there, Dan.
Yeah, you can tell he's so proud to be an Olympian. He's just such a great sport, and what a guy.
Talking of things in Tokyo, what's happening? What's the social activity on Tokyo right now then?
The socials are booming. Yeah, it's just been crazy. I read online that there was 30 million viewers in Japan alone watching the mixed doubles final. So it's just been crazy, exploding on social media. You know, so much hype.
Yeah, it's been great. And I saw on Chengyi Ching's Instagram earlier as well, she posted loads of pictures of the medal ceremony, getting their bronze medals with Lin Wenru. Obviously extremely proud, you know, again, first Olympic mixed doubles event and they've got a bronze medal. So that was all over social media, and great to see that. The comments from fans, like, absolutely loving it.
Yeah, it's amazing. Talking of great matches, we have got the quarterfinals of the men's and women's singles coming up today. Tom, what have we got in store?
It's going to be action-packed. We've got a lot of good games. Starting off with Mima Ito against Jeon Ji-hee from Korea.
Yeah, it's a big one. Next up, we then have Lin Wenru versus Darko Jorgic. Again, a cracking game to look out for.
And then we've got Han Ying from Germany against Sun Ying Sha, who looks really sharp today. That's going to be a good one too.
And then lastly, our match to catch between Hugo Calderano and Dimitrij Ovtcharov. What about that's going to be?
This is what we want to see. We want to see these Clash of the Titan games. That's going to be a really good one.
Definitely. And a match I'm really looking forward to watching is Mima Ito versus Jeon Ji-hee. They've had a lot of good battles in their time, and obviously in the pressure moment in the Olympics, how is Mima Ito going to be able to handle it? And I'm going to be interested to watching that. You know, of course, Harimoto, he stumbled out in the last session, and obviously pressure got to him, I'm guessing. You know, obviously Darko played amazing, but will Mimi Ito be able to carry on the flag for Japan?
She's been good so far. She took out two big games yesterday. She took out Yufu 4-1 from Portugal, and then she's come through another comfortable game 4-0 in her second match. So far, she looks strong, and she's going to be, you know, tough to beat, I think.
Yeah, she's a player that takes initiative. So, again, I can't wait to see that one. And any other matches you're looking forward to, Tom?
Got
to
go into that match to catch a little bit more. I mean, Hugo Calderano against Ovtcharov, that is going to be a good one. I think, for me, that is what I'm really looking forward to. I think, you know, that Hugo's aggressive style, and Dima, when he's on his day, he's a threat to anyone. I think there could be some massive rallies, loop-to-loop. Both those guys have crazy backhands, so we could see some serious shots coming out.
So, of course, with the match to catch, let us know in the comments below what you think the match score will be between Hugo and Dimitrij for your chance to win a signed DHS Tokyo 2020 ball by an Olympian. Cool prize.
Very good prize, so be sure to get those comments in down below.
I guess a couple of players we haven't really mentioned at the minute, Tom, because we're so intrigued by all these upsets, is the Chinese players. Ma Long's playing tomorrow in the quarters against Omar Assar, who's flying.
Yeah, he's been great so far, Omar. He's been great to watch, actually. He's put a lot of effort in his game the last few years, and I'm really pleased for him because I think he's such a likable character. Mm. He's a really friendly, nice guy. So I'm really pleased for him, and I hope he gives a good account of himself against Ma Long. Obviously a tough test. But who knows?
So wherever you are in the world, I hope you enjoyed this episode. Stay tuned for the next episode that gets released tomorrow, 9 a.m. Japanese local time. So that's going to be fun.
Yeah, and don't forget, down tomorrow on the show, we've got Galia Dvorak from Spain, who's competed in the Tokyo 2020 Olympics. So that's going to be really interesting and good fun to chat with her.
It sure will be. So that's it from us today, guys. We'll see you tomorrow. To Tokyo, with love.